Hello everyone, welcome to System Software and Compilers Module 3 lecture video. In this lecture, we will be looking at top-down parsing, recursive descent parsing, first and follow sets. Top-down parsing. Top-down parsing is constructing a parse tree for input stream, starting from the root and creating the nodes of the parse tree in pre-order. Equivalently, top-down parsing can be viewed as finding the leftmost derivation for an input string. At each step of top-down parse, the key problem is that of determining the production to be applied for a non-terminal. Once a production is chosen, the rest of the parsing process consists of matching the terminal symbols in the production body with the input string. Now, let us write the sequence of parse trees for the input id plus id star id using the expression grammar. The expression grammar is e derives t dash, t dash derives plus t dash or epsilon, t derives f t dash, t dash derives star f t dash or epsilon, f derives parenthesized e or id. Now, let us write the sequences of parse trees. First, e derives. The first parse tree contains the root node e. Then, now I need to get the first symbol as id. So from e, to get id I have to use t dash. So in the next tree I'll be using t dash. Then in the next step, from t I need to get the id, so I have to use f t dash. So the next tree becomes T E dash F T dash. Then the next tree becomes E T E dash. This T gives F and T dash. So from F I'll be getting id, right? So like this, if we go on processing and constructing the parse tree, then finally we get the parse tree as e t e dash, t derives f t dash, f derives id, and t dash derives epsilon. This e dash derives plus t e dash. This t derives f t dash. So f t dash. So this f can derive id, and this t dash again derives star F T dash star F T dash, and this T dash, this F derives ID, and this T dash derives epsilon, and this E dash derives epsilon. So this is the parse tree for the input string ID plus ID star ID. Consider the parse tree constructed for the string ID plus ID star ID. At the first E dash node in the pre-order, the production E derives plus T dash is chosen. At the second E dash node, the production E dash derives epsilon is chosen. A predictive parser can choose between E dash productions by looking at the next input symbol. Recursive descent parsing. A recursive descent parsing program consists of a set of procedures, one for each non-terminal. Execution begins with the procedure for the start symbol, which halts and announces success if its procedure body scans the entire input string. Pseudo code for a typical non-terminal is shown. This pseudo code is a non-deterministic one, since it begins by choosing the A production to apply in a manner that is not specified. General recursive descent parsers may require backtracking. That is, it may require repeated scans over the input. However, backtracking is rarely needed to parse programming language constructs. So, backtracking parsers are not seen frequently. Even for situations like natural language parsing, backtracking is not very efficient, and tabular methods such as the dynamic programming algorithm or the method of Early are preferred. To allow backtracking, the procedural code needs to be modified. First, we cannot choose a unique A production at line number 1. So, we must try each of several productions in the same order. Then, failure at line number 7 is not an ultimate failure, but suggests only that we need to return to line number 1 and try another A production. Only if there are no more A productions to try, we declare that an input error has been found. In order to try another A production, we need to be able to reset the input pointer to where it was when we first reached the line number 1. Thus, a local variable is needed to store this input pointer for future use. A left recursive grammar can cause recursive descent parser, even one with backtracking, to go into an infinite loop. That is, when we try to expand a non-terminal A, we may eventually find ourselves again trying to expand A without having consumed any input. consider the grammar. Yes, derives CAD. A derives A, B, or A. To construct a top down parse tree for the input string W equals CAD, we begin with a tree consisting of a single node labeled S and the input pointer pointing to C, the first symbol of W. S has only one production, so we use it to expand S and we obtain the next tree. S derives C A D. The leftmost leaf labeled C matches the first symbol of input W. So we move the pointer to the input pointer to the symbol A, that is the second symbol of W, and we consider the next leaf labeled A. Now we expand A using the first alternative. A derives AB to obtain the tree. So S derives C A D. A derives A B. Here we have the match for the second input symbol A, so advance the input pointer to D. The third input symbol, and compare D against the next leaf labeled B. Since B does not match with D, we report failure and go back to A to see whether there is another alternative for A that has not been tried, but that might produce a match. While going back to A, we must reset the input pointer to position 2, the position it had when we first came to the A, which means that the procedure for A must store the input pointer in a local variable. The second alternative for A produces the tree like S derives C A D, A derives A. The leaf A matches the second symbol of the input string W, and the leaf D matches the third symbol of the input string. Since we have produced a parse tree for W, we halt and announce a successful completion of parsing. First and follow sets. The construction of both top-down and bottom-up parsers is aided by two functions, first and follow, associated with the grammar G. During a top-down parsing, first and follow allow us to choose which production to apply based on the next input symbol. During a panic mode error recovery, the sets of tokens produced by a follower can be used as synchronizing tokens. First of alpha, where alpha is any string of grammar symbols. First of alpha is the set of terminals that begin strings derived from alpha. If alpha derives epsilon, then epsilon is also in first of alpha. For example, in the figure, S derives alpha A beta. If the production A derives C gamma, C gamma, so C is in first of A. We can write first of A is equal to C. To see how the first can be used during predictive parsing, consider the two productions. A derives alpha or beta, where first of alpha and first of beta are disjoint sets. We can then choose between these A productions by looking at the next input symbol A. Since A can be in at most one of first of alpha or first of beta, but not both. For instance, if A is in first of beta, we choose the production A derives beta. Follow set. Follow of non-terminal A is the set of terminals A that can appear immediately to the right of A in some sentential forms. That is, the set of terminals A such that there exists a derivation of the form S derives alpha A beta for some alpha and beta. Note that there may have been symbols between A and A, but at some time during the derivation they derived epsilon and disappeared. In addition, if A can be the rightmost symbol in some sentential form, then dollar is in follow of A. Note that the dollar is a special end marker symbol that is assumed not to be a symbol of any grammar. Computing the first set. To compute first for X for all grammar symbols, apply the rules until no more terminals or epsilon can be added to any first set. If X is a terminal, then first of x is equal to x. And if x is a non-terminal and x derives y1, y2 and so on up to yk is a production for some k greater than or equal to 1, then place the terminal symbol a in first of x if for some I a is in first of yi. So if the a is present in yi, then we need to place this a in first of x, and the previous the before yi, the non terminals from y1 to yi minus 1, the first set of y1 to yi minus 1 will contain epsilon. That is, y1 to yi minus 1 derives epsilon. So, if a is present in yi, then first of yi contains a. So, that a symbol, the terminal symbol, is in first of x. And if epsilon is in first of yj, if first epsilon is present in first of yj for j is equal to 1 to k, means if epsilon is present in all the non-terminals here, the first of these non-terminals, then we need to add epsilon to the first of x. If x derives epsilon is a production, then we need to add epsilon to the first set of x. Computing a follow set. To compute the follow set for non-terminals, we need to apply the following rules until nothing can be added to any follow set. We need to place the dollar symbol in the follow set of S if the symbol S is the start symbol of the grammar. And if there is a production, A derives alpha, B beta, then everything in first of beta, everything in first of beta except the epsilon is in the follow of B. So now beta is following B, hence the whatever present in the first of beta, those symbols are following the non-terminal B. So those symbols, the first set of beta symbols are present in the follow of B. If there is a production, A derives beta, sorry, A derives B, or a production A derives alpha, B, beta, where first of beta contains a epsilon, then everything in follow of A is in follow of B. Let us compute the first and follow set for the expression grammar. The non-left recursive grammar for the expression grammar is E derives T E dash, E dash derives plus T dash or epsilon, T derives F T dash derives star F T dash or epsilon, F derives parenthesized E or ID. So now let us compute the first set for all the non-terminals. So now we consider the first set of F. So first set of F, we can see here the alternative productions for the F are parenthesized E and ID. So this symbol, parenthesis, opening parenthesis and ID, these are terminal symbols. So first of F contains opening parenthesis and ID. These are the first set symbols of the non-terminal F. Now we calculate the first set for T. So now we have got the production T derives FT dash. So in this production, F is the symbol that comes in the first position. So this is considered as alpha. So first of alpha is equal to first of F here. So first of T is equal to first of F. So first of contains opening parenthesis and ID. So the same symbols are present in first of T. So opening parenthesis and ID. In the same way, now we compute first set for E. So here, first set of E is the production is E derives TE dash. So here, the first of if we consider this as a alpha, first of alpha is equal to first of T. So the first of E is equal to the symbol that is in the first position. So first of E is equal to first of T. So again, the same symbols, opening parenthesis and ID, are present in the first of E. Now we consider first of E dash. So first of E dash. So in this production, there are two alternatives for the E dash. So the first symbol is a terminal symbol plus, and in the second alternative we have epsilon. So terminal and epsilon, there are no non-terminals. So hence first of E dash contains plus and epsilon. In the same way, first of T dash is equal to star and epsilon. So now we have computed the first set for all the non-terminals of the grammar. Now we compute the follow set for the same non-terminals of the expression grammar. So the expression grammar is E derives T E dash. E dash derives plus T E dash or epsilon. T derives F T dash. T dash derives star F T dash or epsilon. F derives parenthesized E or ID. So now first we compute the follow set for the non-terminal E. So follow set for non-terminal E includes the dollar symbol, because E is the starting symbol of the grammar. Hence we need to place a dollar symbol in the follow set of the start symbol of the grammar. Then in the production F derives parenthesized E, here closing parenthesis is following the non-terminal E. Hence, closing parenthesis is present in the follow set of E. Now, we find out a follow set for E dash. So, follow set for E dash is equal to follow set of E. Follow set of E dash is equal to follow set of E because E dash is at the end. The rule says that if the non-terminal is at the end of the production, then the follow set of that non-terminal is equal to the follow set of the head of that production. So, follow set of E is equal to follow set of E dash is equal to follow set of E. So, dollar and closing parenthesis. Now, coming to the follow set of T. Follow set of T is equal to here. Now, this if we consider E derives T dash, here this E dash can have epsilon. If the epsilon is substituted here, T will be at the end. So, follow of T is equal to follow of E. So, follow of T is equal to follow of E is dollar and closing parenthesis are present in the follow set of T. And after that, if this E dash is substituted with the this production, that is E dash derives plus T E dash. If this is substituted here, then plus will be following the T, the non-terminal T. So, hence, this plus symbol is also is in the follow set of T. Now, follow of T dash. Follow of T dash is equal to follow of T because T dash is at the end of the production. So, follow of T dash is equal to dollar closing parenthesis and plus. Now, we find the follow set of F. Follow set of F is equal to So, follow set of F, so here we consider this production T derives FT dash and we substitute epsilon for T dash. In that case, F is at the end of the production. So, F is the non-terminal symbol which is at the end of the production. So, T derives F, so the follow of F is equal to follow of T. So, follow of F is equal to follow of T dollar closing parenthesis plus are present in the follow set of F. Then another one, in this production only, if T dash is substituted with star FT dash, then the star symbol is following the non-terminal F. Hence, star is present in the follow set of F. So, now we have seen here how to compute the first set and follow sets.